Greetings to you all. The world we are living in and its political system and its different empires and its rulings are predetermined according to the Lord's revelation in the Word of God, which is the Bible. In the book of Daniel, the prophet, and in the detail it has been given, some of which we are going to see in a clip which is available as a PowerPoint, and I'm just trying to convert for your benefit so that you will stay comforted. If you have placed your trust in the one God, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob. And the seed of Abraham is none but Jesus the Christ. In Him we can stay comforted, for He fulfills the will of the Father, which gives us a great comfort that Jesus the Christ rules over, and He is in control beyond any doubt. So in Him we can take comfort all through. God is in control and takes us through and through according to His plan and will to the end. It will be a glorious end. The end result would be in His Son Jesus the Christ. And shortly and definitely we will be experiencing a 1,000 years of ruling over the face of the earth, under the heaven and above the earth, an ideal government. That ruling would be done by Jesus the Christ, who came in a humble form, and that time all those who belong to Him will be the ruling class. They will be kings and priests and priests. So that will be a glorious ruling. Devil will have nothing to do it. He would be locked down under the pit for 1,000 years. So he has nothing to do, as it happens and as it is going on now. Now the devil has been permitted by the Lord Jesus Christ to roam about. Do not listen to his lies. His lies are religions, idolatry, and to separate the people from the one Lord God and the Redeemer Jesus the Christ, who has given us his life. So stay comforted. It is a predetermined thing that rules over us, from empire after empire. So we will see a small clip that will assure you the Bible is the only Word of God and the truth, and that is the one of the three truth editions of truth, beside the other two, which are the Holy Spirit and the Lord Jesus Christ Himself. He is a personified truth. Stay comforted in Him. We will see the clip as it follows. Jesus the Christ is the one and the only Messiah who's supposed to come into this world, no one else. And His three general appearances: He once appeared, and now He is appearing. He will again appear on the face of the earth. That is given in, and God is in full control in His Son, Jesus the Christ. The Daniel chapter 2 reveals a dream about Nebuchadnezzar, which Daniel has interpreted, and none of his astrologers could do. That is a great statue. And prior to that, and there were two empire. One was Egyptian Empire, another one was the Assyrian Empire, then Babylon Empire. To the Nebuchadnezzar the dream was given, which was golden. Another one is the silver Medo-Persia. Then Greece came, and Roman Empire was still 70 AD ruling
Israelite, and then which is yet to come is another one, which is EU, which will be the mixture of clay and iron. That is not possible, so that will remain for a while, and it is a administration would be unstable, and that will be destroyed by the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. And then he strike at the feet, that is when the EU comes as an empire, then there will be a 1,000-year ruling of Christ Jesus, which will fill the earth, and that is called the theocracy. So Christ will be ruling this world for 1,000 years. That will be a very prosperous year, and blessed are those who enter into that 1,000 year of millennium. We have a perfect salvation, forgiveness of our sin, present security and sustenance and eternal hope in Jesus Christ alone and no one else. And you see the time frame what I have given is, it is written in Hebrew, the three which is past was there, Hebrew 9:25-26, and then future 27-28, he will come, and again the present, he is appearing before the Lord God and his Father as our only advocate and propitiation. For Christ has entered not into the sanctuary made with hands, but into the heavenly sanctuaries. And 25:26, and he offered himself as a sacrifice, eternal sacrifice, because it was predestined and it was appointed even before the foundation of the world as a Lamb of God. He is the only sacrifice foreshadowed by animal sacrifice in the Old Testament, and he is yet to come. So take care and be part of the kingdom of God. Heaven has been defaulted, eternity, eternal life is defaulted in Jesus Christ, and beside him only hellfire. And Israel has failed to recognize their Messiah because they thought they will rule the world and Jesus will come as a political hero. No, so they rejected him on the first place, and now they will receive the false Messiah. God in his Son Jesus Christ, he did a brief work under the heaven and above the earth. That's why he manifested in flesh and blood with a humble birth, as called as Mary's son. Mary yielded completely to the Lord. She surrendered her body. She surrendered her soul completely, and he surrendered her spirit. So as the total availability of Mary for the birth of Jesus Christ to the Father fulfilled everything. So blessed is she. We cannot pray through Mary. So though she has been deified, but she is in heavenly abode. Stay blessed in Jesus Christ. To accept Jesus as Christ the Messiah and your personal Savior and Lord, let your knee bow down before the Lord Jesus Christ. Let your mouth confess. Let your heart believe. Let your heart and mouth disease go off. Let there be no lie. Let there be no scheming. And let there be no idolatry. Take Jesus Christ into your heart. A perfect human right was bestowed in the beginning of the Bible to Adam and Eve. Now at the end of the scripture, a perfect human right is bestowed. He that is unjust, let him be unjust still. And he which is filthy, let him be so filthy still. And he that is righteous, let him be righteous still. And he that is holy, let him be holy still. The Bible explicitly says, apart from holiness, no one will face God. No one can behold God. So holiness is mandatory. Godliness is mandatory. That's why the Bible says, let your spirit, soul, and body be preserved blameless unto the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. The God who has called us, the God who has saved you, will do so. So trust in the faithful God to make you holy and to make you righteous, and have his peace, and wait for the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ in the mid heaven, which is otherwise called the rapture. Set yourself free. Make yourself available to Jesus Christ. Stay blessed. May God bless you. We'll meet in heaven, if not here. Let the kingdom blessings be yours, the righteousness, joy, and peace in the Holy Ghost. Amen.